Welcome to the Fulfilled After 50 podcast. I am your host, Alice Edgerton, and today's episode, we are going to talk about one of the main things I hear women talk about all the time in this season of life is, how do I lose weight? So today's topic and episode is losing weight over 50. So, you know, when we are in the season of life, it is harder for us to lose weight. You know, when we were younger and we talked about, you know, being the thinnest or in the best shape that we could be, more of that was really based on vanity, wasn't it? It's like, you know, we wanted to look the best in that bikini and we wanted to feel great. But in this season of life, as we are entering 50 and over and beyond, it is different, right? So it's not so much about really how we're looking. Honestly, I feel like it's more about, you know, the older we get, it's living longer, living stronger, having more energy, right? It's all those things. It's not so much about how we are looking in that bikini anymore, but it's about how we have the energy to keep up with our grandkids now, right? And being the healthiest that we can be for our kids as they're adults now, and just really enjoying life, but being healthy and happy. So I found, you know, losing weight in this season, hormones play a huge role now. That was not the case then, because estrogen, when we have a lot of estrogen, it's easier for us to drop a couple of pounds. But when that estrogen goes after menopause, then that's where we find a little bit more difficulty to lose that weight. So, you know, the old ways when we were younger, the way we lost weight was we just had like strong willpower. Well, willpower, that's not what it is anymore, right? We can sometimes have the strongest willpower and still feel like, gosh, I cannot budge, right? So that was really one of the old ways of thinking. Another old way of thinking was over-exercising. I can remember like hearing, oh, I've been in the gym 3 hours. I like feel like I need to go to the gym, be in there for 3 hours to be in the best shape. Well, that was old ways of thinking too. Now really 20 minutes of the most effective, like just walking for 20 minutes and then weight training for 20 minutes. You have an effective workout really in 40 minutes. If you're walking 20 minutes and then you just go do a weight routine for 20 minutes, you will lose the weight. And then I think another old way of thinking was these crazy diets that we always hear about. You know, you can hop on that crazy train diet, but it's not sustainable. So how do we lose weight in this season of life? Well, you know, some of the new ways is life has to be enjoyable, right? We're in the season of life and we want to enjoy it, right? Do you not feel that every day is just critical right now? I feel like there's such a sense of urgency for me now in this season of life, and I want to make every day the best that it possibly can be. But, you know, I think it's more focusing on short-term goals, because we want to be able to enjoy that piece of cake if we're going to somebody's birthday party or if we're going to a wedding, and it's looking at those special times that you have coming up. So, you know, your short-term goals is, what can I eat today to get me to that goal so I can enjoy that little piece of cake later on at that special occasion? So that's one new way that is sort of, it changes. And then we need to find something that's easy to follow. It needs to be simple and sustainable and safe. So it's really those three S's. You want to pick something that's going to be simple, safe, and sustainable. For me, that just happens to be intermittent fasting. It works. We sort of unconsciously intermittent fast because, let's say, you know, you go to bed at 9 o'clock. I know I am a 5 a.m. girl, so I'm usually in bed at 9, but my last meal is at 6 o'clock. So you say, well, you know, I get hungry and I want a snack in the kitchen. Well, turn the lights out. Just turn the lights out, go upstairs, read a book, do something that distracts you. And, or you can fix like a cup of hot tea. That is a great deterrent too for you want to grab something in the kitchen. But at 6 o'clock, lights are out and I don't have anything else after 6 o'clock. And then by 11 o'clock, that's been a good 16, 17 hour fast. It's sort of, it's simple, it's easy, it's sustainable. You're giving your body a rest. And so then your insulin level, you're not going through those insulin spikes. So that's a lot of what happens in this season of life as well. And then you want it to be effective. So for me, intermittent fasting has been really, really effective, but you got to find out what works for you. And so one of those things that works all the time, I hear it all the time, people like, I can't lose weight. I'm doing everything I can. I just can't lose weight. I'm like, well, have you tracked everything you're eating? Have you gone to MyFitnessPal and just tracked everything you're putting in your mouth? I can guarantee you one of those things is going to be high in sugar. Either you're having a soda during the day or some kind of packaged food. One of the first three ingredients is going to be sugar. So I can guarantee you if you cut out the sugar in your life, you're going to drop the weight. Because as women in this season of life, it all accrues around our belly, right? We're getting that little belly budge. Well, that's because for one, our hormones have changed, and two, it's the sugar. And then our fiber intake is not as high. So there's two things automatically that you can do today is lower the sugar and increase your fiber intake. Have at least 30 grams of fiber a day. How can you do that? Is start out in the morning with a bowl of fruit, and fruit meaning raspberries, blackberries, strawberries, blueberries. Have that cup of fruit with your 20 ounces of water. So you're hitting that water, you're hitting your fruit, you're getting that fiber intake, and then at lunch, have a great big salad with either a grilled chicken or some kind of nice fish on it, or you can have maybe some kind of like flank steak on there. Have a big salad with protein on it. You're getting so much good vegetables and fiber on that. And then your dinner, basically your 3/4 of your plate is filled with fresh vegetables and then have a protein on it. I guarantee you, if you eat that way, you're gonna lose the weight. So there's three things to do, okay? One is increase your exercise. Not only is it just, are you gonna unconsciously lose some weight, but you're gonna build up your endurance, you're gonna build up your stamina, you're gonna build up your energy. There's lots of things you can do, even if your knees are hurting, your shoulders are hurting, you know, you got joints and aches problems. Just a short walk or sitting in the chair lifting weight. I know my husband, when he's like watching TV, I gave him these strength balls. So he is doing like 100 on each hand, squeezing these strength balls just to increase his hand strength and his wrist strength. How many of you go to open a jar and you're like, oh gosh, my strength is, I'm losing it in my hands, right? Well, that's because we're not building up that hand strength. So do something that you can just sit in a chair. The second thing, guys, is when you are in the grocery store or when you are eating, is look at the first three ingredients of what you are eating. If sugar is in one of the top three ingredients that you are eating, throw it away. Don't eat it, because all that's going to do is increase that belly fat. So decrease your sugar. Try to make baby steps. Cut out a soda if you are a soda drinker, and decrease and make your goal to be zero sugar. And then just have that on special occasions. That's not saying that you can never have it again in your life, but just have it on a special occasion that you are looking forward to go celebrate. And then the third thing, guys, is you want to have a plan that's effective. So put it on a short-term goal. Map out your month and see what can you cut out and what can you increase to meet your goal of losing a couple of pounds this month. I would love to hear your comments below on the podcast of, you know, what you are doing just to make 2020 your best year and getting you healthier. It's about enjoying life, but it's about being your healthiest that you can be as well, because your food goes along with your health, goes along with your mind and your thoughts and the way we live day to day. So if you have not subscribed to this podcast, I would love for you to hit the subscription button. If you are not in our Fulfilled After 55O group, 5-0 over at Facebook, come over there, guys. We would love to have you. Amazing group of women. And if you are just curious, then go to fulfilledafter50.com and you can see what kind of courses and services that we have there as well. But remember to say some kind words as you are out and about today, because you never know. The smile on your face can change the way somebody's day is going today. So I encourage you is to go out and make an impact in the world, and it can be just as simple as a smile on your face today. Have a great day. Subscribe to the podcast and catch us next week for a new episode. Bye, everybody.